Hi everyone, my name is Pauline and I'm a nuclear medicine resident from Belgium. Today we will take a deeper look into one of the treatment options for patients with Alzheimer's disease. The current available FDA-approved dementia drugs cannot slow or stop the progression of the disease, but they can ease the symptoms and help you continue much of what you've always done. How do they do that? Let's take a look inside the brain. The human brain contains an estimated 86 billion neurons. This means that there are 10 times more neurons in my head than people on Earth, and all of those are in use. It is therefore no surprise that the brain is the most complex organ of our body. Neurons communicate with each other by passing special chemical messages called neurotransmitters back and forth. One of those neurotransmitters is acetylcholine. It is this communication that allows our brain to think, learn, and remember things. To sort of regulate this process, you have an enzyme that constantly breaks down acetylcholine. Think of this enzyme as Pac-Man and all of these acetylcholines as the little dots that he eats. Some of the dots are being eaten and some are communicating. It's all about finding that perfect balance. Like my mom always says, too much of something is never a good idea. This enzyme makes sure that there's always just enough neurotransmitter present and that our brains can work perfectly. The name of this enzyme is acetylcholinesterase. Now I've told you how neurotransmitters work in a healthy brain, but what happens in patients with Alzheimer's? In Alzheimer's disease, brain cells that use acetylcholine die and connections among cells are lost. This is why the brains of people with Alzheimer's become much smaller compared to a healthy brain. Acetylcholine plays an important role in memory function, so the loss of these neurons explains the memory problems associated with Alzheimer's. We have not yet managed to find a drug that can fix the lost brain cells, but we can try to make the still surviving brain cells work harder, so that they can, to a certain extent, compensate for the lost brain cells. More specifically, the drugs that are given in Alzheimer's disease try to increase the levels of acetylcholine in the still surviving brain cells by blocking the working of acetylcholinesterase. Acetylcholinesterase was the Pac-Man that had to maintain a perfect balance by eating some of the dots, remember? That's why the drugs are called acetylcholinesterase inhibitors. Think of cholinesterase inhibitors as the ghost in Pac-Man, who prevents acetylcholinesterase from doing its job of eating the dots. This will result in an increased amount of acetylcholine in the surviving brain cells, and this will improve memory problems for a limited period of time. Acetylcholinesterase inhibitors should be initiated as early as possible in the course of this disease. These drugs won't have any effect if the majority of the brain cells have already died and if there's no acetylcholine left. If treatment is well tolerated, it should be continued for as long as there's no clear evidence of progression of dementia. Since cholinesterase inhibitors do not change the course of the disease, some families choose to stop treatment after a 6-month trial if there has been no improvement. It is important, however, that families understand that patients are not going to regain lost functions and that no change is a positive outcome when treating patients with Alzheimer's. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have a question about dementia that you would like me to answer in one of my next videos, please leave a comment below.